Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once more to Gallic Grisby's War in the East. So in the last session, we did actually pull off a magnificent advance. We did lose a few men over here in the push to try and establish ourselves across the river. It didn't go as well as I hoped, and didn't really go too well over here trying to create something of a mini pocket. That would have been amazing, but there's a motorized division there as well. But it will come, it will come. Now what the hell was I going to do with this motorized division? Do I move it over there? Do I? What I'm going to do actually is I'm going to break it up into a brigade. And I'm going to have one move over here. Okay. These will be on reserve. And the reason for that is I don't want these forces breaking out over here and heading towards my headquarters, airfields, and forward. Engineers. So yeah, there we go. That's one little small change. That should hopefully lead to a lot. Now then, we are going to also change our doctrines, when I can remember how to do that. Right. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Ground attack, we're going to put that up to 200. Oh, not? Can I not? What the hell? Ground support, yep. Okay. Why can I put out? How odd. Okay, we'll put ground support up then. How odd. Anyway, moving on. I thought I would be able to change that. Let's see. A reconnaissance in here. Righto. So then they can actually move forward. What is your headquarter? Headquarters is over here. We'll have the headquarters based over here then. In Pskov. Right. Move these airfields up. Okay. Need to move forward on these rails. Yep, can move all the way to Politosk. And there we go. We'll have the 2nd Panzer Group headquarters over there. 2nd Army, yeah, I've still draw supply from this area, so we'll move the headquarters over here. There we go. Okay, we do have our transports on the rails here. We can keep them in position for the time being. Let's see. Why the hell do they have a Pioneer Battalion attached to them? That's ridiculous. Okay. We'll have that attached to the 2nd Panzer Group, actually. Why the hell did they have that? That was a waste of time. Okay. So we have Army Group North over here, and that's really not a good thing to have. What the hell am I doing? Okay, thankfully we can move them via rail. That is superb. And something that we really need to do, because I have that headquarters over there. That really, really isn't a good thing. What the hell was I thinking? Okay. Well, I'm glad that's sorted. Good thing they were on the rail line too. There we go, and they're off the rail line now. Okay. Now, we do have these two divisions over here, these two static divisions. Let's take a look. So we have 18th and 16th Army. Let's see. Headquarters. We'll sort by... Whoops, armies. Let's see. So 16 farming and 18 farming. They're both about 16 and 17, which isn't good. Their strength is rather high. I could assign them to 18 farming, considering that 18 farming is actually lower in strength than 16 farming. They're actually higher in... that's interesting. I imagine it must be due to core commanders. But then again, they do have a few extra cores, don't they? That's a good point. Ah, well, actually, what we could do then, which is a nice solution to our issues from before, is we could have one of these, well, we could have two of these divisions assigned to this core over here, so then at least we can actually build up a little bit more strength and use another core over here. That'd work out quite nice. Okay, that'll work. That will work. Right. So we can make it to over here, which we'll do. Now, do I have the divisions assigned over here, or do I have them assigned over here? It's a difficult question. I'm going to be incredibly interested to see how the Red Army responds in the following phase. That's what's going to be the intriguing thing. Okay, so we do have some good movement. We could move... I'll just move on the rail line. For the time being. There we go. So this is 23rd. Okay, that's nice. 23rd, good. There we go. These guys should feel quite happy about that. Right. So that has actually... fetters rather negatively. But we do have that little bit more strength in the army now. We're up to 381,000 men. So it's difficult to balance. Right, we do have the Panzer headquarters, which is under 9th Army, which is rather interesting. I'd imagine I'd be able to put that under 3rd Panzer Group. Which Panzer Group did we conclude that actually lacked... pause. Okay. Right. 3rd Panzer Group, 2nd Panzer Group. So we have 1, 2, 3. God damn. Okay, so we have 4 assigned to 2nd Panzer. We have 2 assigned to 3rd Panzer. Then we have 2 assigned to 4th Panzer. That's incredible. Okay, so 2nd Panzer has the greatest amount of logistical support. Right. Okay, that gives me an idea. How much does 1st Panzer have? 3. Okay, that works. Okay, so I know exactly what to do now. So this command over here. This command can be assigned to one of the Panzer Groups, and then the other one can be assigned to the other Panzer Group. Can I move it by rail? I should be able to over here. Yeah. Luckily, actually. I only saved a little bit of time there, but hey, it saves us. Just a little bit. Okay, so we'll move up over here. Okay. Now we'll have this assigned to... Yeah, it's interesting because obviously we are very spread out. We'll have it assigned to 3rd Panzer. Right, so 3rd Panzer. Then whoa. Ooh, okay. That was expensive. Yeah, that was really expensive, actually. I didn't actually anticipate that being so costly. Okay. So we'll have these guys taken to Riga. Whoops. Yeah, and then from Riga, they can go up to the islands just off the coast of Estonia, and we can clear those ports there. Now, somebody actually messaged me with a shortcut on how to skip, well, at least speed this up. Let's see. There is it. Ah, right, space. Okay. Okay, there we go. So we can have them moved out over there, they can take the port, and that'd be fine. This headquarters. Ooh. It is difficult, isn't it? I don't think this was the best choice of rail lines, actually. It's the most obvious one, but considering the distance, probably not the best. Okay. They're on the train regardless. Can have them moved out in the following turn. Okay. Right, we have 4th army. See, you're attached to army group center. I'll have you attached to the... Which army is this? Is this 4th army? I'll have you attached to the 4th army. Or do I? I guess. Right, we'll go with 4th army then. Oh, it's actually 3, so that's quite nice. Right, 4th army. No more movement there. Just a shame. Okay, the security detachment. I will have to have that moved. Where do we want to have it moved? Indeed. Ah. Veliki Luki. Veliki would be a good city to move it to. Though I could move these guys from Vitebsk and not actually make it. Okay. Fair enough. There we go. Probably a little bit too far. Yeah, perfect. Okay, now, we need to support the advance to the south. Let's see, we need to identify where the enemy is weak. So the enemy is fairly weak, just in general. So that's quite nice. It does definitely help me out regarding breaking through the line here, which was never going to be much of an issue. But let's see. Terrain-wise, probably over here due to the fact that there's a little bit of swamp, but we are across the river then. We are good against them. I suppose we need to drive towards Bryansk. That is the objective, okay. So 4th army is issued the objective of Bryansk. Now, do I push forward with the division here? They are lacking, so I will use them to give us the frontage. Okay. Now, if I can punch through, probably in this area, we could try to move towards Bryansk from the south. So we do have good movement from here. Let's see. Actually, what do I need to do here? Let's go to this equipment. Units. Okay. What am I looking for? I'm looking for heavy artillery. AT artillery. Okay. Kinda looking for heavy guns. Let's see. Maybe my men. Right. Let's go with Germany. Battalion. Okay. Heavy howitzers. Equipment then probably would be it. No. What I need to do then is production. Right, so Germany. Show types. Look for... yeah. So we do have super heavy artillery. Let's see. Right, so they're in the actual cores here. Okay. So we have the 355 howitzers. They're in this group over here. I would like to have them moved out. We'd be much better having that in the 18th Army or in the Army's assault in Moscow. That would definitely help. Yeah, so we'll take that out. Okay. Yeah, there's also the 305, so we only have one 355 and then five 305s. Huge guns. So we'll have them moved. Let's have it moved into the 18th Army. Do we have it moved into the 18th Army? Yeah. Yeah, maybe. Oh, okay. Yeah, let's go with the 18th Army. That's one. Can I change their headquarters from here? Guess not. Supply details. Okay. These are with 9th Army actually, which is fine by me. But I'll have them moved up to 9th Army so I can assign them to the actual core I'd like. Right, so we'll have that moved up to 9th Army. Okay. Now, the last one. Which is in here anyway. Okay, so this is 2nd Army. Right, let's move this up to 9th Army. There we go. So we've got a lot of heavy artillery then, just in that area. So we need to distribute in the following turns, which we'll be able to do, which will be nice. Okay, now moving on to this. I know I just went off on a wild tangent there, just all of a sudden. Okay, 3 there, but 7. 8 here. We'll move here then. Okay. Do I have range with planes? Right, we'll launch an attack here. Why can I not see details? Okay. Actually did a nice bit of damage. And then over here as well, launch. Okay. Now we should be able to break through there with only using a... never mind. Hate when I'm wrong. Luckily I can move through here. Okay. So we have Naval Infantry Rifle Division. Or we have a rifle and the 50th Army. And we'll push against the 50th Army. Do we push against the 50th Army? See, I'd like to push against both armies. Well, both forces, actually. Okay, we'll use these guys here. God damn it. Right, we'll push here to the south then. Oh, well, we have 12th army. Did they really just hold again? Finally. Oh, shizer. That's a 14th tank division. Okay. That's not something we fuck around with. Okay. So we have 14th, we have 1st tank division 2. Form a line. Yeah, there's a lot of tanks in this area. We'll occupy this position here. Right, motorized. Further armored. And these are armored divisions, too. Though these ones seem fairly fresh, perhaps? Okay, occupy the town. Okay, there we go. Nope, no more there. Okay, so it's fairly easy movement. Just basically pushing up. Though we do have a breach in the center, so we'll be able to work on that. Which will be quite nice, and will lead to good things in the future. We did actually disturb a headquarters, so that was good. Okay. What sort of movement would I have if I broke them up? Not that much of a difference, really. Okay. Let's move over here, across the river. They're gonna hold. Okay, difficult. Very difficult. Two NKVD mortars. Sorry, brigades. The one division here should be sufficient to break through. Should. Hopefully. Oh, there's only 2,000 men. But I can't cross. Okay, that's weird. Right, shattered. Really? Oh, okay. That's rather irritating. Who do you belong to? Hmm. Okay, two cavalry divisions should be easy to get by. Good. Cavalry and a rifle. Can I get some more reconnaissance going? I don't trust that only being one defense. I suppose that is true, apparently. Try and break. Oh, wow. Okay. Wow. Yep, much easier than I imagined. Or not. So those forces are cut off, I can use the division here. Yep, there we go. That's another 200 odd guns. Not guns. Okay. We still have two divisions here. We'll occupy the town. There we go, just rub those headquarters. Oh wow. Seems our forces could go quite far. Where do we want to go? I mean, there's so many airfields here. Let's see, if I break this down into brigades, not so much. But if I do that, then I definitely cut that division off. But we'll go this way. Awesome. Captured the town as well, of Lubny. A little bit of supply there. Okay, we'll move here then. Only scouted. God damn it. Move further over here. Awesome. Okay, make up a bit of frontage, I should say. With a varied assault there. Nah, bugger, might as well go deep. I mean, we do have quite the movement range. keep moving this. And there we go. Move them all the way up. A lot of headquarters in this area. Should be able to drive towards Poltava fairly easily, in all honesty. But I will use you. Oh. Again, hopefully. Right, they're technically cut off now. We'll drive through these forces over here. Hopefully this should damage a number of planes. Either way, it is definitely disrupting the Soviet Air Force in the area. So what we'll do is we should really be bombing these. Right. Yeah, disrupting headquarters as well. Okay. Who are you? Okay, you're under this command then. That's fine. Just shift them up the line. Okay. Now these forces need to try to come around here. And hopefully we can try to... Okay, I guess not. I guess it's just not on the cards for this time. Ah, well, we'll use these infantry anyway. Let's get a bit of frontage going. Especially over here. Right. Obviously, these guys are ranged. Okay. The situation is a little bit weird. I don't know. I actually. What to do? Yeah, they only have 2% fuel. Now, I could use a cavalry over here, and then with the cavalry we ride into all of these airfields, we disrupt all these airfields, cut all these forces off here, and yeah, that should really screw the Soviets over here. Then it bags us a nice amount of fuel and a little bit of supply, all good things really. Definitely. Have they lost anything then in terms of planes so far? Air losses. Right, 138 at the moment. Lost on the ground. Just hold that there. Okay, now if I move here, I can definitely cut it off. There we go. Now whether that holds, I do not know, but if I move that, just make it a little bit more difficult. It's not probably going to hold unless I move like actual panzers. Okay, these forces are cut off though, so that's good news. I can use Romanian forces here, break them, and then we can move on. Use three divisions here. Terrific. Now, I think we do have enough infantry in the south. I know it's going to be difficult, but I'd rather give infantry support to my panzers over here. I think that's the most important thing. Because we are going to need infantry to back us up. Occupy the city. Okay, a few resources, nothing really too exciting. Now, we'll have this reassigned to LIV. LIV. Ooh, okay, we're now out to admin points. Okay, I suppose that was worthwhile. Right. Choose these remaining forces then. Oh, do we go for a full attack on Odessa? Okay, we're going to use whatever planes we have in the area. I'm going to attack those units. Right. So, select all. I'm going to send huge raids here. Okay. Is that enough? No, it's not really, is it? So that's what? 3, 6, 9, 13. 8 won't be enough, but if we hit them, it'll... I don't know, it'll weaken them a little bit. We need to weaken them. Hopefully that airstrike did cause some disruption. We'll see. Ah. Awesome, surrendered and routed. So Odessa falls with very small amount of men lost, actually. So that's awesome. I mean, we've just gained access to all that fuel and supply there. Fantastic. And importantly, we have a port, which is really nice. Move these troops up as well. Right, so that went really well. I'm actually really surprised that went as well as it did. But I'm glad it did. Okay. Move these men over here. There we go. Double up there. I'm really happy that Odessa did fall. Really opens things up for me now. Okay. Right, hit that with two divisions. That ain't gonna go well. Okay. Now, lovely that we have the river here. So we are going to form, hopefully, a pocket this turn. That I intend to hold. Right, so occupy the city. I can't believe they gave up the city. That was absolute madness of them. Okay. So I'm going to hit that there. So what do we have here then? We have two armies and a rifle division. Right, two armies and a rifle division. See, they don't have the range and I wouldn't have them do that anyway. Okay. So move here. And here. Okay, that's what I need. Now break up into brigades. Right, what do we have here? That is a fairly strong force. I do have the air landing division over here, so I can split that up. Yeah, this is absolutely amazing for us, though. Okay, air landing. Good. Really good. Okay. Oh! Shattered, wow. Yeah, I guess they had absolutely no strength. This pocket's doomed. They do have that port there. so they'll be able to get some supply, but ultimately nowhere near enough to really prevent the inevitable. So that's good then. Right, who are you attached to? You over here. It's only cavalry. I'll have to find something to do with them. Right, I can disrupt that even further. I mean, absolutely huge disruptions to the southern air forces of the Red Army. Yeah, so they have lost a few planes there. Okay. Now then, I need to make sure I can cut these guys off. Let's move these forces here. I need to cut them off and protect myself. Oh boy. Right, that's absolutely zero fuel there. We need to get fuel into that ASAP. Is that it? What is it like for supply? Nothing either. It looks as though it's just had to abandon everything. Okay. That's not good then. At least there's some fuel in there. And to say they've got to supply all of this, then yeah, that's pretty awful. Okay. So what we'll do then is, what do we do? Break you up into the brigades. Going to protect our rear. Yeah, this Panzer group desperately needs fuel. That counterattack by the Soviets did really... It kind of did do a little bit of damage. Right, plenty of fuel and etc. here. Oh boy. Oh wow. So we can sweep south? Though their strength is rather low. Why is their strength so low? I suppose... Actually, it's not a very strong motorized division, is it? Okay. Right, now considering the fact that... Yeah, we're going to have these panzers. The motorized and panzers. We're going to have the 14th... Panzer Corps advance towards Stalin now. That's the idea. Right. Move here. Or I can try and sweep up north. We'll see how things come out. But that's in a major city just taken here. Major. Major disappointment. Yeah, need to keep on pressing forward. Sweep north though, just to pressure these guys. Cross the river. Okay, now the panzers. I desperately need to get fuel in here. I don't know, maybe in the following turn I might consider actually having like a full halt of the Panzer forces and just going for a HQ build-up. That might be what is required. Okay, I could move in here, which I will do. Oh my god, look at that defensive value. Right, surround it. Notice the defensive value decreases. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, I think a full halt with the Panzer group here is honestly going to be required. There's just nothing left to give at the moment. We have pushed them quite hard. At least we do have the flank secure. We do have this, I kinda guess. I don't know, maybe. I don't really think so, but hey, worthwhile, see what goes on. We're not far at all from Stalino. Stalino is only a few miles away. That's a lot there. We also do have Makiva. There's a lot of resources. We have Golovka. A lot of resources. Beyond those cities, we have Rostov. Another objective. To the north, we do have Kharkov. But Kharkov might be reached by infantry, honestly. I don't know. Do I keep on pushing towards Stalingrad? I guess with the panzers, I do need to sweep around. But I think a turn to build up their fuel is honestly not going to be a bad idea. Considering that the infantry are moving ahead quite nicely now, we have definitely broken across the River Dnepr. Oh, sorry, Desna. Is this the Desna? The River Desna. Oh, no, there is a River Dnepr. I was right the first time. So, yeah, we do need to take objectives into consideration. There's bigger things afoot in the north, i.e. the push on Leningrad and the push on Moscow. So there is a lot going on. And frankly, I need fuel. I need fuel. If I don't have fuel, I can't do anything. So, yeah. I think from the following turn, unless there is a gigantic precedent. Yeah, look at all that movement. So this is what you can do with 124% fuel. Now, bear in mind the fact that we have, like, just 20-odd percent fuel in our forces. Says a lot, doesn't it? Right. I mean, there's a lot to be said for having it assigned to another force like panzers. Well, sorry, infantry, but it's just not going to work, is it? Right, 7 fuel there, so don't want to have them in there. See, I... Right, 169. That's really set me back in terms of fuel. But there we go, we have some SS motorized. So at least the panzer group has been reinforced, so that's good. That's going to give us a lot of well, flexibility in the future. Can't afford to have them change headquarters. That's rather annoying. Okay, either though, we'll move on. We'll keep these airfields as they are for the moment. Okay, so that's practically everything moved. We do have the Finnish forces over here, actually. Right, what to do with them, really? That's the thing. can't attack here, which is rather annoying. The good news is they have put a bloody tank division on that front, which is really good. Honestly, it doesn't make any sense, but hey. Can't move any further over here. There we go. So I guess what we'll do then is we'll do a round of bombing the airfields. So at the moment we have 171, we have lost 43 planes this turn. Let's see if we can inflict some losses upon the Red Army. Well, sorry, upon the Red Air Force. Which I feel we should. I mean, considering that these airfields have been forced to move, they should, yeah, they seem to be losing a lot. That's good news. That seems to be it. Yep, there we go. But still, 337 there. That's good. Right then, so I do think we are all but done. We have moved all of the rails. Yep. Actually, I should move them forward, otherwise we are going to be behind, aren't we? So we will move up then. Okay. Awesome. Okay. At last. Right then. Going to head towards the rails. Alas, we can get on with that then. Ah, okay. There we go. Oh, right, yes, the SS forces in the center. Captured another town. There we go. The thing is, we're basically moving through here just to capture it and make sure it's all clear. Okay, we do have the Italian forces. They will become very useful. Oh. Okay. Oh, too much rail cost, isn't it? Okay, that's fine. There's no other reinforcements. What we'll do then is we'll have them ready to move in the following turn then. Okay. We'll move them out as a group in the following phase, and I'd rather move them all together than separately. We do have some Romanian forces over here, just some cavalry. Never a bad thing to have. Okay. They can't be moved though, so we'll leave them as they are. Right. Okay, seems fairly good. Seems fairly good. Let's consider the fuel supply. What am I going to need more fuel for? I don't think I'm... do I need more fuel for this? I don't think so. I guess we are going to spot the panzer divisions down here. Okay. Oh, okay. A little weird that we can use fighters to drop fuel. I guess... do have some transport. Oh, these are just escorts, aren't they? Yeah, okay. I send a lot of escorts. 24 fuel. Hmm. Okay, probably not the best idea. Eighteen fuel. If I can get some fuel in here, that'd be cool. Yeah, bugger it, I'll send that fuel. 18. Okay, should I send some supply? Supply's good. Supply's good. Supply not good. Supply not good at all. Supply not good. Oh boy. Is that it? Fuck. Well, shit. Oh, wow. Okay, I'll call that then. In fact, I'd like to keep some security around here. Okay. Right, we'll keep it as that, man. So that was fairly cool. A lot of things hopefully will happen this turn. Really do hope. Okay. So we'll bring it to a close here, then. Morale, yep, incredibly poor. So, yep, we'll bring it at close here then. That has been pretty cool. I probably missed something somewhere, but we'll be okay. The good news is we have stabilized the situation in the, well, in the center. So that's always a good thing. Always a goddamn good thing when you can stabilize something. We are extremely close to Moscow. Extremely. Should be able to take out a few more units in the following phase, hopefully. Most importantly, these forces around Smolensk, so that's going to open this up so we can move. Right. This is the theatre just north of the Pripyat Marshes. See the amount of armour they have here. A lot of armour. Interdicted. Yeah, just causing disruption, which is the most important thing. Okay. There's really nothing in myself at the moment. I'm not surprised about that, considering the sheer threat to Leningrad and the sheer threat to Moscow at the moment. I'm glad that we were able to threaten both cities at the same time. Right, they're broken out of that, that's fine. I kind of expected them to... Is it that one I was thinking of? No, I don't think it is that one. But it might have been, I don't know. Either way, we can do it next turn. And push onto Poltava. Poltava to, yeah. So Kharkov's definitely going to be an infantry objective, considering the distance that we have to go is not far off. Oh, did this hold? If that did hold, that's really good. I better hold. I better hold. Yeah. Okay. Moscow's looking incredibly lightly defended at the moment. Right, they pushed back some infantry. That's fine. The thing is, they're concentrating strength against something that ultimately doesn't matter. And my forces will pull back. Okay, interesting. I can work with that. Right. Hold. Right, they didn't hold. That's a shame. They did come under heavy attack. The good news is we do have enough width to hold it. Yep, they held. Held. Heavy losses there. They'll collapse eventually. And we'll have that pocket there. I need to see what they do around Moscow. It does seem as though they are trying to threaten the north of our advance there. Well, the north of the army group center as we begin our advance on Moscow. We were pushed back a little bit on our advance to Ladoga, but the thing is, we frankly have more than enough force to hold it. I think we have enough to hold it. And those forces that were used against our armor to push them back, they've left themselves out of position now. Right, here we go, let's see. Yep, see, we're not far from hitting the lake here. That's good news. Okay. The jaws are closing around Leningrad at the moment. We're not far from linking up with the Finnish front as well, which would be nice, get some supply flowing through there. Obviously, it's not going to flow through there real well, but ah well. Okay. Ground loss is fairly light. Fairly light. Let's survey the situation. Okay, so at the moment, there's fuck all between us and Moscow. Let's do the reconnaissance. Right, so the limit of the range. Okay, so there is some forces over here, so it's not going to be quite as easy as I would have hoped for. But Yeah, we should have enough fuel to push on through here. There's a large amount of them here. Yep, these forces have been taken. Oh, we got these to the south as well. Alright, these guys aren't... What the fuck? What? What? Did I miss something? Like, you know, the couple thousand men who just apparently got by? They didn't actually receive reinforcements this time. Fantastic. So everything they have is just what's been redeployed. Yeah, so this was quite nice itself. So we got these forces here. That's two tank divisions. We got three rifle divisions here. A tank, cavalry, NKVD, rifle, two cavalry and a rifle, another rifle. Okay, then over here, of course, we got these forces. That's good. Right. So yeah, we did hold here. You can see that they have really pushed men over here. It may not be a simple task this turn to get to Ladoga, but we will bloody well try. We must reach Lake Ladoga. If I can reach Lake Ladoga this turn, I will be happy. But just look at this. Look at the sheer amount of men they have deployed against us. This is incredible. We should be able to break through here. If I break through the center, we can create a pocket here. Okay. It's going to be hard going. It's going to be bloody well hard going. But we will break through. We will get through. Right. Can't attack there. At least we can see what's going on. Okay. See, they're trying to form around me. I have so much room here. They've pulled back to reserve. They're just abandoning ground. Consider that only a turn ago we were on the other side of this, and it was looking incredibly difficult to get by. And now things are just opening up. We're really pushing hard. We've got some encirclements down here. Really important encirclements. We should be able to possibly drive on towards Kharkov. Right, have you assigned? Ah, didn't mean to do that. Fuck. Yep, that's free. Awesome. 76% fuel. That is so, so much fuel. So much. Oh god, I was gonna say, like, what have we got, like, a laser? Okay. This is good news. Yep, there's something in the center here. We do have some reinforcements from the rest of the Reich. We have gained another infantry division, the blue. And we're still, importantly, on turn 11. So we still have time. I think we're just coming towards the end of August now. Okay. Discover these forces. Right, that should be more than enough. I was hoping they would rout, in all honesty. Yeah, we've got the two divisions here as well. So frankly, it's going to be really interesting. It's going to be so very interesting. And I do have these forces here. So honestly, depending on how things go, we might be able to push through here. But this is stiff resistance. But the thing is, the resistance is here rather than around the city. So that's draining the defenses of the city. And then they still have to contend with the 18th army. And then they have the 16th army over here that is going to push and is going to push hard on them. We are going to really drag this open. We're going to split the corpse with the Soviet Union in half, and we are going to open this up. I really don't know if we'll be able to pull this off in the following turn. It's going to be difficult. There's a lot in our way. And it is definitely shrinking down. I may have to just try and dig in as much as possible to hold it. But again, we'll have to see. There's much to be done. And, my god. Apparently they just completely abandoned this. Apparently so. Just insane. Absolutely insane. We can reach the Desna. Could I reach Bryansk in this turn? No, I couldn't. But that's due to the fact that we just don't have the supplies to reach that. If we did, then we'd be able to be there. But we're going to be able to be in a position to be there by next turn. And then we can start turning towards like Tula and Moscow. Or we can just keep on pushing. This is it. This is it. I need to move the 16th army up. But I think this is going to be done in the next session. I'd like to take a look at this fresh, and then we'll work things out. But yeah, things went fairly well there. We were pushed back a little bit, like over here, but we only pushed back two hexes, a hex here too, but we kept that open. Yeah. We didn't lose any armored fighter vehicles, which is important. But you see, they lost almost 1,000 men for that. We did lose one over here, with almost 1,000 men. Okay, the issue is their defensive ability here is rather high. It might be that we try to break through here and worm our way in, but I don't know. There's a lot of strength here. There's, in fact, a huge amount of strength. There's probably more strength here than there is really protecting Moscow at the moment. So pushing on Leningrad is going to be a difficult process and might take potentially 2 to 3 turns. But Moscow, whole other situation there. We'll destroy these forces, capture those men. That should probably take us up to 2.5 million losses perhaps for the Soviets. Which will be sweet. Okay. How do we compare in terms of numbers? So at the moment we have 5,254 armored fighter vehicles ready for action. The Soviets have 6,288, so their numbers are dropping dramatically. Absolutely. So I don't know. I think we should have enough force in the north to do this. It's going to be bloody hard. It's going to be really difficult, but the hardest task has already been achieved, just getting through here. So we will have to figure this one out. Yeah, you can see they're digging in as well. Well, they're not digging in here. So we need to burst through here. We need to get to the city. We need to push and push and push. We need to force them out of position. We need to push them between the hammer and the anvil, and then we can crush these forces. I will try my best to reach Ladoga in this turn. I think I can pull it off. I think I can. It's going to be fucking difficult, but I think I can. We are going to have to use the entirety of these two panzer groups to their full effect to be able to do this. It's going to be a bloody difficult task. 16th Army is really going to have to pull its finger down its arse and really hold this open. But I think we'll be able to hold it. We do have a lot of space. The Soviets are pushing men up to us. But look at this. What do we have here? Security, NKVD. Two security here. Division there. Get that out of the way. Boom. Path to Moscow's open. We can head towards Kabinka. I think we'll set Kabinka as our objective for 2nd Panzer. Okay, we do have a decent amount of fuel. 38. Okay, we'll form the division together. 33% here. That's an actual division, that's... Yeah, okay. It's 38. So we could reach Borodino in this turn fairly easily. So yes, guys, I will let you have a look at this and I will let you tell me what you think. I still don't know what the hell happened down here, though. Where the hell did all these men go? I'm really disappointed by that. I mean, that was going to be a nice encirclement as well. That would have been really nice. But apparently they disappeared. So, yeah, okay. That happened. So yes, until next time, guys. And if you have enjoyed this, do consider backing me on Patreon. It does make a huge difference and does allow me to keep on doing this. So until next time, thank you for watching. Have a great day wherever you are, whatever you're doing, and see you all in the future. Goodbye for now. Stay classy.